Senator Frank Blas Jr., of course, a candidate, Republican candidate, to the delegate's position. What do you have to say? Look at the people of Guam and tell them Frank Blas and the sincerity he's had. And they think you're running on one issue only, compact impact reimbursement.
No.
And of course, that is something that you've been diligent at. I know from the very start, if it wasn't for your diligence, a lot of people won't know how much is owed, and you had to seek out how much was owed. Our incumbent delegate says in Liberation Day Parade, says the war reparation is still alive. But, you know, they're still alive, but almost on a daily basis, people are dying.
Yeah. Thank you, Jess, because you're right. My campaign is not just, focused on one issue. My campaign is focused on the issue of bringing Guam's voice to Washington, D.C., and representing Guam in ways that it hasn't been represented. And as a result of that, there are many issues that need to be resolved, that I feel that Guam has to be a part of the conversations. There were many opportunities that we have had, or that we could have had, to be able to resolve a number of the different issues. But because
missed
opportunities, but because conversations weren't had, and there were, we were talking to the wrong people in some cases, these opportunities didn't have. Let's talk about the military buildup. It's the responsibility of our representation to be able to push that. If there were issues, there should have been communications back to Guam with regards to what those issues are and see how we can help to move this forward. Obviously now the Senate has some issue with regards to the Department of Defense and where that's at. The war claims, it's really not about the money. It's about the recognition that our people deserve. And there was an opportunity to be able to get our foot in the door and to move that forward that wasn't taken. Of course, you've got your compact impact. Then you've got the other issues that basically affect the lives, our daily lives. There are issues such as the cost of living on Guam. Mm-hmm. Our water and our power and the cost of our food, they're all directly related to how we are represented in Washington, mm-hmm. D.C. If you were to do a comparison of what the cost of food was and what the cost of living was 10 years ago, and you look at it today, it's a significant difference. Why is
this? And wages haven't gone up.
And wages haven't gone up because there haven't been discussions. Mm-hmm. There hasn't been that, hey, wait a minute, that's not good for Guam. Okay? And a number of times, though, that was taken at the expense of being able to follow a party line. Mm-hmm. There are times when you're going to follow the party line based on the tenets and based on the principles that would be good. I have no qualms with that. There are some Democratic issues that I agree with, and there are some Republican issues I agree with. It's you've got to be able to represent the people of Guam. It's not about the party, it's about the people. Yes, I'm going to be aligned to the Republican Party because I believe in in the tenets of the party. But my job, first and foremost, is to represent the people of Guam and to knock on those doors, to have those conversations with the individuals that we need to have these conversations with, to make sure that what they hear and what they know about Guam, is if it's erroneous, let's look to correcting it. The Veterans Administration. In 2009, I went to the Veterans Administration. One of the things that concerned me is that the information that they had for Guam was erroneous. When I brought it to them and I said, have you talked to a representative about this? And when I got the response back, sorry, Senator, we haven't been able to meet him.
Hmm.
Okay.
Meet him?
Well, and it's issues such as this.
Meet him, and it's her. It was her.
And I had to correct them. I said, I'm sorry, but our representative is female, gracious lady, and please have the communications with her. I don't know whether the communications, it's one thing to be able to have the communications with the secretary, but it's another thing to be able to have communications with those individuals that are going to be responsible for carrying out the national policies and the mandates and stuff. And that's where we have to become effective. If we can't vote on it, let's find ways to be able to look to see how we can get ourselves
it's included. It's one thing riding an Air Force One. You better be nice to the guy that fills up your tank.
Well, and I tell you, so that's the Frank Blas that I'm asking people to consider. I'm an individual that, my grandkids right now, I'm going to say hi to them because they're watching me at home. And, I've got my vested interests. It's not just in my home front, but in the home front of everybody else.
Senator, hey, thank you very much. I'll talk to you again. Of course, probably maybe after the primary when you go into the
general
election. But good luck again.
Thank you.
Good luck. Thank you very much.
Okay, buddy.
Join me tomorrow morning, Missile 63, tomorrow radio stage for more talk. Let's talk about this and much more. This is tomorrow morning, Missile 63. It's good night for now.